This edition of Tech Talk is brought to you by GlobalSpeak.com, new media consultants, corporate video and audio communications, video and audio production and distribution, live and virtual event production. Tag TV and Tag Radio is a service of GlobalSpeak.com, creatively delivering powerful marketing, video, and audio solutions. Patrick, welcome to Tech Talk.
Hi, Frank.
Well, go ahead. You want to thank me? Go right ahead, Patrick.
Yeah, I was going to say thanks for the invitation. I'm delighted to be on the show.
Actually, we're flattered to have you. There's anyone that knows Patrick certainly knows. I'm thinking like 9-10 years on the board of the Technology Association, a couple of years as chairman. I know that you've been an active participant right across the board, just about in every vertical in one way or another, but sales, marketing, cybersecurity, just a number of different things over the course of your career. Obviously, one of the great and exciting things that it's sort of like the challenge has arisen, and sometimes they say the right person for the right time. Security, in this case, technology security, is a big issue. You can't pick up a newspaper without or watch a cable television without hearing more and more about some of the things that have happened lately, both pretty scary from a standpoint of politics, but even more so from the standpoint of some lost data and technology innovation. Let's talk about something that's really all kind of new, I think, and pretty exciting, NTSC, National Technology Security Coalition. Give us some insight.
So the NTSC, the National Technology Security Coalition, it's a nonprofit, nonpartisan organization, and fundamentally it's focused on driving the national dialogue on technology security. Hmm. It's comprised of a board of directors, which is chief information security officers from across the nation, some of our country's largest firms. We have an advisory committee that's comprised of security stakeholders, senior executives from firms that surround the chief information security officers, and then we have a policy council that's comprised of legislative affairs folks who help us draft our legislative agenda. So that's the NTSC.
Pretty impressive. How did it get organized? And it's relatively new, right? How did it get established?
Well, it started out earlier this year, and it emerged from the Technology Association of Georgia, from TAG, as part of TAG's quantum growth strategy. And the TAG board looked at all the clusters surrounding the state of Georgia, and we have FinTech, and we have Health IT, and we have logistics and data centers and supply chain. But they decided that technology security was the right focus given how topical security is at the moment and considering how strong the state of Georgia is in the area of security. And I think you know this list, but we have 115 security companies. Mm. We rank third in the nation in terms of cyber revenue. We have 8 nationally recognized cyber programs at universities and colleges across the state. We have 8 military installations in the state, including the U.S. Cyber Command Center at Fort Gordon and the U.S. Army Cyber School, which is co-located at the NSA facility at Fort Gordon. 8 of the top defense contractors have a presence in the state. So wow. Cyber is really the nexus of what's happening in the state among all of our clusters. And so the TAG board felt like if we could create an organization that had a national identity focused on cyber, it would help the state, but it would also be good for the folks that are going to be involved in it.
Now, am I correct in saying you've been asked to be the chair of the organization?
No, I'm the executive director.
Executive director, I'm sorry.
Yeah, of the NTSC. We have a board of directors, and the chair of our board of directors is Tim Callahan, who's the global CISO, the global chief information security officer for AFLAC. And in addition to Tim, we have 12 board members that have been confirmed. And as of about 2 hours ago, we have our 8th verbal, and we're actually processing those verbal commitments. So by December 31st, we'll have 21 members on our board of directors.
You know, I can't think of another person that could just kind of, almost, and I don't want to make light of it, but literally in less than a year period of time, anyone that's listening to our conversation today, it sounds like an organization that's been vetted and built over a decade, and instead it's been probably a little more than 10 months or so that you've been able to accomplish what you've done, Patrick. That is absolutely impressive. And the second part, let me continue real quick and say that going through the list of assets that we have, I mean, it's very reminiscent of when TAG will do some of where Georgia leads and produce a map. You know, it isn't until you really go through the different things that we're involved in that you begin to realize the incredible position we already hold as far as security is concerned, and the kind of companies and technology innovation that's already in place right here in Atlanta. Go ahead.
Yeah, and that's true. And two things. One, I've only been on board for 3 months and a week.
Oh, so. Rub it in.
It's really exciting because I have been, greatly encouraged by the feedback we're getting across the CISO community. The fact that this is going to be a national organization, the fact that we are recruiting chief information security officers from across the country. We're talking to folks on the West Coast. The conversation we had earlier today was in Chicago. We had Helen Patton, who's the chief information security officer for Ohio State University, recent join, and the CISO Marlene Allison for Johnson & Johnson recently joined, and Mark Varner from McDonald's. So we're adding, Fortune 500, Fortune 1000 names in the top academic institutions. So we're really excited about how those individuals view the organization and the fact that they're excited about being on board, because as we go to, what are we trying to do and how are we doing it, the overarching mission of the NTSC is to be the national voice of the chief information security officer in Washington, D.C. And what we consistently hear from the CISOs we talk to is that there isn't one organization that's exclusively focused on being their voice on the Hill.
Well, and I have to apologize. One of the things, if you know Patrick, you know you have a good friend, and I've known Patrick for well over a decade, and I've taken advantage of that and making a light and having some fun with you on our interview today, Patrick, but it's a serious subject, and I cannot think of somebody that's in the right place at the right time that could do a better job. And the amazing part, if it's been only less than 4 months, it's even more incredible what's already been put together over that short period of time. Let's talk about value proposition. I think that's something as a CEO, or at least a chief C-level executive for many years, it's something you've had to deal with for a long time. But what's the value proposition for a chief information security officer, especially a nationwide player who wants to join the NTSC?
Well, I think it breaks down to three basic things. Unification around voice and standards. As I said earlier, having a unified voice on the Hill for chief information security officers and really the security industry at large at both the federal and state level. Standardization of laws, policies, certifications at the national level, policy leadership, policy guidance, the ability for a CISO to influence a policy or a piece of legislation that's in formation, or to come in and help to, perhaps change a policy or impact a piece of legislation that doesn't necessarily serve them. The second thing is awareness. The ability for the CISO to become aware of, policy trends and changes that could impact their businesses, a distilled pipeline of security information, advocacy, and awareness of security policy and information by lawmakers, what's happening on the Hill, feeding that to them. And then finally, thought leadership. And when you think about thought leadership, it's the ability to provide meaningful content, and that content comes from some of the finest minds in cybersecurity, be it from a Fortune 1000 CISO, a top cyber firm, a top academic institution like Georgia Tech, Ohio State, Stanford. The intent is to create a resource that becomes a go-to destination for every executive involved in technology security in the country.
Wow. I mean, it's just impressive, and it's one of those things where it had to have the inevitable need for this situation. And again, the right place, right time, right person. You mentioned impact of voice. Let's talk a little bit about some of the primary issues in terms of what are a few of the national legislative and regulatory policy issues that the CISOs, as the acronym is, and that's Chief Information Security Officer, is going to have to deal with.
So some of the ones that have arisen that, there's strong unification in terms of folks are saying, yes, this is something we want to focus on, national data breach notification legislation. It has been bouncing around the Hill for nearly a decade. It is challenging for multi-location companies who get breached, and then they have to deal with the breach notification laws in 47 different states, the District of Columbia, Guam, Virgin Islands. There are a lot of places that have their own unique notification regulations. And so if I'm a quick serve restaurant with locations across the country and I get breached, not only do I have to deal with the state attorney generals in the states where I get breached, I have to deal with the AGs in the states where I didn't get breached to convince them I didn't get breached. So we think it's important that we create a national policy around that. And so we're going to be focusing on that, I think, pretty hard in 2017. The entire encryption debate is important and vital as a nation. And with the myriad of thinking that exists around backdoors and encryption, it's going to be a very robust conversation coming into the next year. Guidelines governing the export of intrusion software is another issue that's really critical. So I can't use the same software in Boston to support my organization in London because intrusion software got wrapped up in an agreement that now makes it almost a weapon, and export of weapons is challenging. And there are other two things, the FTC and some of their engagement in data security and, what we think might be overreach. And, we want to have some conversations with them. So there's some preliminary issues arising, but we will have a 2017 legislative agenda, which we will publish early in 2017, focusing on the key issues that we're really going to try and attack in 2017.
Well, it's a massive situation, lots of layers and tentacles, lots of complications, as you mentioned, when you're dealing on a global basis and all of the cultural and even technical aspects of having to deal globally come into play, and certainly security has got to be right at the top. There's nothing happening in any vertical that's, unless it's secure. Can we identify, because you've gone through so many things, pick and choose, or maybe you've already outlined some of the key initiatives for next year, just exactly what are you guys going to be up to, NTSC, as far as 2017?
So part of, as I talked about policy, I talked about thought leadership, and one of the other areas that I didn't discuss is events, and that's to provide opportunities for our board of directors and our advisory committee and policy panel to engage in executive peer-to-peer conversations across the country, be it through, our legislative fly-in to the nation's capital in April, our regional CISO policy roundtables, which will happen around the country, and our national policy conference, which will happen in Atlanta next October. And the goal is to create unique forums where CISOs can engage their peers and other executives from stakeholder firms. And this is not about CISOs attending heavily attended vendor conferences, which they have ample opportunity to do every year. They're going to be designed to be more intimate. And, will there be vendors in attendance? Of course there will, but there'll be senior executives who can provide, again, that peer-to-peer dialogue. So one of the key initiatives is to ensure our key events are successful. And if you take the legislative fly-in and five policy roundtables in the National Policy Conference, so we have seven key events in 2017. We want to complete and publish our 2017 legislative agenda. We want to develop our lobbying presence on the Hill. We will have a presence on the Hill, folks stopping in to talk to the key legislators that influence cybersecurity legislation across the country. And then continuing to build our board of directors and our advisory panels, or this advisory committee or the policy panel. We have 21 board members today. We include the eight folks who have given us verbals in the last 2 weeks that we're processing. Our real objective is to have about 60 chief information security officers on our board of directors by mid-year next year, and that would be basically 10 from every region across the country. So that's kind of the small things we're trying to get accomplished, Frank.
And I was going to say, and that's just the first month. I know in you it's going to be 2017 is going to be an incredible year, and what a great asset, what a perfect addition to the ever-growing leadership of Atlanta and the greater technology community as far as the state of Georgia. Right, again, I've said it a couple of times, I'll say it again, Patrick, congratulations, but right place, right time, right person. Thank you so much for all the years of commitment and loyalty and dedication to TAG, and also best wishes on what's going to be, I think, an exciting new career as far as this whole organization is concerned, National Technology Security Coalition. Patrick, thank you so much for taking time out of what's got to be a crazy, crazy planning situation and heading towards a new year, but to take a few moments to explain to our TAG members and some of our listeners just what the NTSC is all about.
Well, thank you for the invitation to get on the TAG radio and to talk about it. And just as a quick reminder for those folks who want to learn more, there are two ways you can do that. You can go to www.npsc.org and get some more information about us. Or if you want to reach out directly to me, you can send me an email at patrick@npsc.org. And I'd love to talk to you if you're interested in being involved with the organization.